position battle and the turnover battle are going to be two big keys to see who gets out of here with a victory. With that, we head upstate to Jacksonville and a rainy Everbank Field. We say hello to our broadcast team, our Brandon Gotti and Charles Davis.
Welcome again, everybody, with Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gotti, and yes, the rain is falling now, and it is supposed to continue to fall throughout this game. So how do you think that will impact this contest?
Well, first and foremost, both quarterbacks are going to make sure the officials have those dry footballs coming in each and every play and standing over them sometimes with a towel before the center gets up there to snap it. Second thing is the focus of all the guys who handle the football. Do they wear gloves? Do they take them off? Will they carry the ball high and tight to make sure they have good ball security? That's paramount in a game like this.
And a touchdown, a two-point conversion, and a field goal. Pretty good start to the drive, though.
Yeah, good start to the drive, but the urgency has to really be increased by both players on the field and everyone on the sidelines. Got to make sure everyone is up and into this game.
Here's Jackson. Looking to throw on second down. Incomplete.
That incompletion was caused by the defense. I think they were trying to get one into the middle of the field, trying to find a receiver there. But they were in zone defense. What are the advantages of being in zone? Eyes and reaction. Eyes meaning all eyes are on the quarterback, and they're going to react when he throws the ball.
He's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Dante Fowler. Coming in and dressing for a loss of eight, and it'll be fourth down.
Well, if an offense is going to throw the ball in this part of the field, any pass rusher will tell you that's his favorite part. Gets a chance to get after the quarterback. It's almost like a reverse red zone. They can create points using their defense, and this time they took it.
Now he's into the clear. Pass the 20. And all the way in for a touchdown. Vernon Davis. Guys have made this a one-score game now. So it was fourth down. They go deep to try to pick up the first. They pick up more than that. They pick up a score.
I'm not even sure the analytics guys would think that was a good gamble. Fourth down, they're going for it. But they pressed the issue. And not only did they complete the pass downfield, how about the run after catch that ends up culminating in a touchdown? That's a huge play.
As we get set for a big two-point conversion. Throwing is Jackson. Eluding the pressure right. And this is caught. They got it. And that could be an important 2 points that gets him back within a field goal. I guess the coach looked at the two-point cheat sheet, said go for it, get it to a three-point game, and they did it.
And sometimes you just throw out time of game. You don't worry about that. There's just a feel sometimes in making that call. And he felt good about what he had for a two-point conversion. And now they're only down three and feeling great about themselves.
Here's Tucker now out to kick this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. Here comes the Jaguars' offense as they get set here. Right now, these guys are shuffling a little bit, maybe doubting, because three straight drives have ended with them punting the football away.
Yes, you start pointing fingers at each other a little bit, asking a lot of questions. What are you seeing? What are you getting? Maybe trying to narrow down your playbook a little bit and maybe get simpler.